Hello everyone, I'm Meeru from Pinnacle Online Coaching Classes
and we are going to do part 2 of Tier 2 paper 625.
I have already done part 1 for you. Paper number 625 is going to be done in this video lecture. There are total 4 parts to paper code 625. This lecture, it's a part of a series that Pinnacle has started from paper code 601 to 640. I'm going to do total 40 papers of English for you. Similarly, for maths also, from paper code 701 to 740, 40 papers of maths are going to be done. And these papers for Tier 2 are going to be accompanied by a video explanation for each and every question. Some of our videos are going to be in the public domain. For others, if you wish to watch them, you wish to take up these test series, then you need to visit our website sscclpinnacle.com. Visit our website and join our test series so that you can take the maximum advantage of all these video lectures. This is a previous year paper. Paper number 625 to 631 are going to be previous year's papers, and this paper was held on the 12th of April 2015. Part 1 has already been done for you. Now let's begin with part 2. Directions, question number 43 to 52. In the following passage, some of the words have been left out. Read the passage carefully and choose the correct answer to each question out of the 4 alternatives and fill in the blanks. Now we are going to do a close test. A close test means to be done. A man stopped at a flower shop to dash some flowers to be dashed to his mother who lived 200 miles dash. As he got out of his car, he noticed a young girl sitting on the footpath sobbing. He asked her what was wrong and she dashed, "I wanted to buy a red rose for my mother, but I only have 75 cents and a rose costs $2. The man replied and said, "Come dash in with me. I will dash you a rose." He bought the little girl her rose and ordered his own mother's flowers. As they were dashed, he offered the girl a ride home. She said, "Yes, please, you can take me to my mother." She directed him to a cemetery. Dash, she placed the rose on a freshly dug grave. The man returned to the flower shop, cancelled the delivery order, dashed up a bouquet and dashed 200 miles to his mother's house. So this is a close test, and in close tests, you have to first read the passage to get a feel of it. Now this is a kind of a small short story which has been told to us through this passage, and I'm going to do this for you. For passages, a little bit of reading, a little bit of knowledge of grammar, a little bit of vocabulary, especially usage of prepositions, all this is needed. Now let's do. And practice. The more you practice, the better you perform. A man stopped at a flower shop to dash some flowers to be dashed to his mother. Now we have two here. Two is followed by first form of the verb. Here ordering and requesting, both of them get cancelled out. What are we left with? We are left with request and order. So a man stopped at a flower shop to order flowers. Why will he request some flowers? No, at shops you're going to place an order. So at a flower shop to order some flowers to be posted to his mother's, given to his mother's, taken to his mother's, delivered. Whenever we place an order with a shop, they are going to deliver. Doesn't the delivery boy come to deliver the pizza? So deliver. Some flowers to be delivered to his mother who lived 200 miles beyond, between, away or across, 200 miles away. Away is my answer. As he got out of his car, he noticed a young girl sitting on the footpath sobbing. He asked her what was wrong and she inquired. Inquired is used for, it's a very formal word. Inquire is used for when you're asking something at an inquiry counter. So, "and she replied" is going to be the right one. What did the girl reply? "I wanted to buy a red rose for my mother, but I only have 75 cents and a rose costs $2. The man replied and said, "Come dash in with me." Question number 47. What are my options for question number 47? For question number 47, my options are, come off in with me, come out in with me, come upon in with me, come on in with me. This is going to be the right one, come on in with me. I will, now with will, I will buy you a rose. This is a sentence of simple present. I will buy you a rose. 48, will buy you a rose. He bought the little girl her rose and ordered his own mother's flowers. As they were dash 49, as they were coming, he offered the girl a ride home. As they were relaxing, he offered the girl a ride home. Relaxing, you can see it in the very first look, this will be eliminated. As they were leaving or as they were going. Question number 49, as they were leaving the shop, as they were leaving, he offered the girl a ride home. She said, yes, please, you can take me to my mother. She directed him to a cemetery. Question number 50, were, where and where. Here we have four words which sound so similar, pronounced similarly, but meaning is different. This were, it's a helping verb, where, okay. This is a noun. Now where, to wear clothes, this is a verb, and where, where. So this where is the correct one, option D. Where she placed the rose on a freshly dug grave. The man returned to the flower shop, cancelled the delivery, question number 51, okay, cancelled the delivery, picked up a bouquet, and here it is in past tense, the man returned to the flower shop, cancelled the delivery, so picking and putting gets eliminated, because when I have done in simple past tense for you in the grammar video, that when a number of things happen one after another in the past, for all we'll use simple past. The man returned to the flower shop, cancelled the delivery order, picked up a bouquet and drove 200 miles to his mother's house. Very, very simple. All should be correct. All should be correct. Then we have question number 53 to 57. While threatening the dash of universal values, the campaign to spread democracy will not succeed. The 20th century dash that states could not simply remake the world or abbreviate historical transformations, nor can they easily affect social change by transferring institutions dash borders. Even within the ranks of territorial nation states, the conditions for dash democratic governments are rare. An existing state enjoying legitimacy, consent, and the ability to mediate conflicts between groups. Without such consensus, there is no single sovereign people and therefore no dash for arithmetical majorities. This is my passage, which is on a little on the difficult side. It is not as easy as the previous one. Now let us see question number 53. While threatening the integrity of universal values, the campaign to spread democracy will not succeed. The 20th century showed that states could not simply remake the world or abbreviate historical transformations, nor can they easily affect social change by transferring institutions. Then we have point 55, by transferring institutions across borders. Even within the ranks of territorial nation states, the conditions for effective democratic governments, those governments which can actually give results, are rare. An existing state enjoying legitimacy, consent, and ability to mediate conflicts between groups. Without such consensus, there is no single sovereign people and therefore no legitimacy for arithmetical majorities. In this one, even if you get 4 out of 5 correct, that's okay. This was on the difficult side. Question number 58 to 67. Now, this is one pass. This paper, you will have a close test even in the latter part of the paper. All of them are not together. So, now let's move on to question number 58 to 67. In the following questions, read the passage carefully and choose the best answer to each question out of the 4 alternatives. Let me first read the passage for you. As you can see, the length of the passage is small. The recent change to all volunteer armed forces in the United States will eventually produce a gradual increase in the proportion of women in the armed forces and in the variety of women's assignments, but probably not the dramatic gains for women that might have been expected. This is so evenly though the armed forces operate in the ethos of institutional change oriented toward occupational equality and under the federal sanction of equal pay for equal work. The difficulty is that women are unlikely to be trained for any direct combat operations. A significant proportion of the larger society remains uncomfortable as yet with extending equality in this direction. Therefore, for women in the military, the search for equality will still be based on functional equivalence, not identity or even similarity of task. Opportunities seem certain to rise. The growing emphasis on deterrence is bound to offer increasing scope for women to become involved in novel types of non-combat military assignments. Basically, it's about the role of women in the armed forces. It's about that. Now, let us see. Which sentence is an incorrect one? Question number 58. Which sentence is an incorrect one? My options are: the recent change to all voluntary armed forces in US will produce a gradual increase in the proportion of women. Okay, now this is given in the very first line. Anyway, we'll discuss that later. Next one is: the difficulty is that women are likely to be trained for any direct combat operation. Opportunities seem certain to rise. And the last is: the difficulty is that women are unlikely to be trained for any direct combat action. This is question number 58. Now, for this, the answer is: the difficulty is that women are likely to be trained for any direct combat action. This is the incorrect one. The first one is given in the very first line. The recent change to all volunteer armed forces in the United States will eventually produce a gradual increase in the proportion of women, given in the very first line. Opportunities seem certain. See, if you see this line here, it is opportunities seem certain to arise. So this one is also correct. Option C is also correct. The difficulty is that women are unlikely to be trained for any direct combat action. If you see this line, the difficulty is that women are unlikely to be trained for any direct combat action. So this is also right. What is incorrect? The difficulty is that women are likely to be trained for any direct combat action. That's why I say that what SSC gives is not difficult in comprehension, but it's tricky. On the very first reading, you might feel, oh, this is correct. But here there is unlikely and here there is likely. Answers can be picked up 50% of the times directly from the passage. So question number 58, my answer is going to be B. Next is question number 59. A suitable title for the passage might be. What can be a suitable title for the passage? Current status of women in US military, current status of women in US Navy, current status of women in Air Force, or current status of women in teaching service. This can be directly eliminated from the very first look. Very clearly it is given here, the recent change to all volunteer armed forces in the United States. In the United States. So it is about the military. Question number 59, answer is going to be A. Question number 60. According to the passage, despite the United States Armed Forces' commitment to occupational equality of women in the military, certain other factors preclude women being assigned all of the military tasks that are assigned to men, drawing assignments from a wider range of assignments than before, having access to positions of responsibility, or receiving equal pay for equal work. This is question number 60. Here, being assigned all the military tasks that are assigned to men. Here it is, a significant portion of larger society remains uncomfortable as yet with extending equality in this direction. Therefore, women in the military, the search for equality will still be based on functional equivalence, not identity or even similarity of task. So, this is the answer. Question number 60. The passage implies which of the following is a factor conducive to a more equitable representation of women in the United States Armed Forces than has existed in the past? Question number 61. Now, options are all volunteer character of the present armed forces. Answer for question number 61 is going to be A. 62. The primary purpose of the passages. What is the purpose of the passage? Present an overview of different types of assignments available to women. Analyze reforms in the new United States All Volunteer Armed Forces necessitated by the increasing number of women in the military. Present the new United States All Volunteer Armed Forces as a model case for equal employment policies in the action. Or present a recent prognosis of the status of women in the new United States All Volunteer Armed Forces. Option D. Now for question number 62, answer is D. They are presenting a reasonable prognosis of for the status of women in the United States All Volunteer Armed Forces. Option B and D were close, but answer for this one is going to be D. Question number 63. Which of the following is closest in sense to the word novel used in the passage? Novel used in the passage, the word novel has been used in the last line. The growing emphasis on deterrence is bound to offer an increasing scope for women to become involved in novel types of non-combat military assignments. So what do we mean by novel, N-O-V-E-L, novel in question number 63? Novel here means new. It's a novel idea. That means it's a new idea. Question number 63A. Next is question number 64. It can be inferred from the passage that after the recent change, some join willingly, some are forced. Everyone joins the military under compulsion. Men are forced, women join willingly. Everyone joins the military willingly. So this is question number 64. Question number 64, everyone joins the military willingly. Out of these four options, this is nowhere mentioned. Sometimes you have to follow the elimination technique. This is also nowhere mentioned. Men are forced is also nowhere mentioned. When these three get eliminated, so we'll go with option D. Rarely will you get a question on inference, assumption, etc. But here you have one, 64. Question number 65. The word opportunities used in the passage may be replaced by all except. May be replaced by all except. Here we have opportunities seem certain to rise. Here we have opportunities. Okay. Openings seem certain to rise. Failures seem certain to rise. Scope seems certain to rise. Prospects seem certain to rise. Here for this question, question number 65, all can be used except for the word failures. So option B, question 65, option B. Question number 66, it can be inferred from the passage that the change to all volunteer armed forces took place many years ago. This cannot be inferred because in the very first line it is given, it's a recent change. Opportunities for women in military are certain to decline. This is incorrect, given very clearly here opportunities seem certain to rise, so this can neither be inferred. Let's see option D. The society encourages increased participation of women in direct combat. It is not so. It is very given very clearly here. The difficulty is that women are unlikely to be trained for any direct combat. The government sanctions equal pay for equal work. This can be inferred. 66C. 67. Question number 67. The dramatic gains for women and change in the attitude of a significant proportion of the larger society are logically related to each other in as much as the author puts forward the latter as the major reason for absence of the former, a public response to achievement of the former, a reason for some of the former being lost again, and a precondition for any prospect of achieving the former. Question number 67, answer is D, a precondition for any prospect of achieving the former. That was the last one to be done in that comprehension. Now let's move on to question number 68 to 77. In the following questions, read the passage carefully and choose the best answer to each question out of the four alternatives. A small band of biologists share a dream to find species of sea or land animals hitherto completely unknown, or to discover living examples of animals thought to have died out ages ago. Finds made in this century encourage these dreamers, whose field is apathy, named cryptozoology. Literally, the signs of hidden animals. Size and habitat are often responsible for an animal's having been overlooked. Not surprisingly, bumblebee-sized bat that lives in caves in Thailand eluded detection until 1973. But larger animals in less remote sites have also remained hidden. Herds of a species of peccary, supposedly extinct since the last ice age, for instance, were found in Paraguay in 1975. Native people sometimes offer scientists useful clues. An unusual feather in a local's hat sparked the discovery of a showy African peacock in 1936, and accounts of giant lizards on the Indonesian island of Komodo proved not to be mere myth when naturalist P. A. Owens identified four of the creatures captured in 1912. As cryptozoologists follow, such leads into little explored areas, they remain optimistic that it is not too late to uncover sensational surprises. So this is the passage about unknown species, about cryptozoologists, etc. So now question number 68. Myths refer to love stories, historical places or traditional stories. Myths refer to legends. Question number 68, answer is C, legends. Next question number 69. A bumblebee-sized bat that lives in caves in Thailand was discovered in. Very simple. See, here it is. Not surprisingly, bumblebee-sized bat that lives in caves in Thailand eluded detection until 1973. Very clearly given in this line. So question number 69. Answer is going to be A, 1973. Next question number 70. Dash still look forward to discovering sensational surprises. Who looks forward to discovering sensational surprises? Okay, now let us see here. P. A. Owens, the natives, the naturalist, or a small band of biologists. Last line. As cryptozoologists follow such leads into little explored areas, they remain optimistic that it is not too late to uncover sensational surprises. And what does this they refer to? This they refers to cryptobiologists. Cryptobiologists, question number 70. So here it answer is going to be a small band of biologists. A small band of biologists, that's good. Here, see, here it is given, a small band of biologists, and these have been later referred to as cryptobiologists throughout the passage. 70D. 71, question number 71. Often the cryptobiologists get a lot of leads from native people, animal size and habitat, myths or legends. Question number 71. Now, the answer for this one is going to be native people. Question number 71, answer is A, native people. Native people sometimes offer scientists very useful clues. 72. The dream of the cryptobiologist. The dream of the cryptobiologist is to find species of sea or land animals hitherto completely known, all of the given options, living examples of animals thought to have died years ago, hidden supposedly extinct species. Question number 72. Answer is living examples of animals thought to have died years ago. Next is question number 73. Herds of species of peccary, supposedly extinct since the last ice age, were discovered in. So when were they discovered? Here it is given. Herds of a species of peccary, supposedly extinct since the last ice age, for instance, were found in Paraguay in 1975. So question number 73, answer is D. Don't you think this was a very, very simple question? Yes, it was. Question number 73, answer is going to be D. Next, question number 74. An unusual feather in a local's hat sparked the discovery of a showy African peacock in 1936, 1973, 1975 or 1912. Now here it is, see, discovery of a showy African peacock in 1936 accounts of very clearly given an unusual feather. An unusual feather in a local's hat sparked the discovery of a showy African peacock in 1936. Question number 74, answer is A. 75. Giant lizards on the Indonesian island of Komodo were discovered in. They were discovered in which year? So let us find, try to find the answer. Accounts of giant lizards on the Indonesian island of Komodo proved not to be mere myth when naturalist P.A. Owens identified four of the creatures captured in the year 1912. So question number 75, answer is going to be C, 1912. 76. It is the dash of the cryptobiologists that keep their dream alive. Spirit finding, love for adventure, or curiosity. Question number 76. It is the finding of the cryptobiologists that keep their dream alive. Question number 76, B. Next, question number 77. Often dash responsible for an animal having been overlooked. The uniqueness of the animals themselves is responsible for an animal being overlooked. The resigning nature of the scientists themselves, the size and habitat or unexplored areas remain. Question number 77, size and habitat. Often the size and habitat are responsible for an animal having been overlooked. Now, where is the answer in the passage? Here it is. Size and habitat are often responsible for an animal's having been overlooked. Here is the answer. So, question number 77, C is the answer. Question number 78 to 87. Now, we are going to do idioms and phrases. Your passages were on the tough side. And that is why during my presentation on how to prepare for English, I have told you very clearly that you will lose marks in comprehension. Try to control them. Question number 78 to 87. In the following questions, four alternatives are given for idiom phrases printed in bold in the sentence. Choose the alternative which best expresses the meaning. 78. Sheila's tall tales have no meaning. Question number 78. Jealousy, greed, boasting or pride. Here the answer is going to be boasting. To tell tall tales means to boast, to brag about something. Question number 78, answer is C. 79. The bridge gave way under the heavy weight. What do we mean by give way? One, give way means to give passage to somebody to go. Okay. Even during traffic jams, ambulances are given way. Here my options are collapsed, withhold, endured or stooped. S-T-T-O-P-D, stooped. For question number 79, answer is collapsed. During the heavy rain, the bridge gave way. This is a phrasal verb. So make sure you know the meaning. 79A. Question number 80. His plan was so complicated that it floored his listeners. Encouraged, entertained, annoyed or puzzled. Question number 80, answer is going to be D. The very word complicated will tell you very clearly that there's going to be a negative word here. So here it is going to be puzzled. Puzzled is the right meaning. Okay. Question number 80. But if I say everyone was floored by his speech, that means everybody was impressed by his speech. 81. My uncle's business has gone to the dogs. Is ruined, is sick, is dead, is angry. Question number 81, answer is going to be A, it is ruined. My uncle's business is ruined. During the recession, the manufacturing industries have gone to the dogs. That means they have been badly affected in the negative way. 82, despite the highs and lows, life tends to average itself out. This is not a common one, to average itself out, balance itself, be unvarying, show equal value or to get compatible. Question number 82. Answer is going to be balance itself. To even things out. It will mean question number 82. Answer is to balance itself. Question number 83. On second thoughts, she refused to accept his invitation. On second thoughts, on reconsidering, reviewing leisurely moral grounds or seeing his brashness. Question number 83, answer will be A, on reconsidering or on rethinking about something. Initially you decide something and then you, when you reconsider it, then you come to another conclusion. So that is known as second thoughts. 84, I stirred the hornet's nest by my honest statement. This is quite a common one, very, very common one, to stir a hornet's nest, to respond to criticism angrily, cause anger in many people, stopped people criticizing someone, acted with energy and interest. Question number 84, answer will be B, caused anger in many people. 85, I know how to break in horses. Rare, train, tend or force. This is also not common at all. Question number 85, answer is C, I know how to train. I know how to train. 86, the judge declared the argument null and void. The judge declared the argument null and void, empty, annulled, unavoidable or not binding. These are my options. Question number 86, not binding, not effective anymore. The rule has become null and void. So answer will be D, 86D. 87, we should bury the hatchet and become friends. Hatchet is a very small weapon, a very small weapon. Okay. What? So if you are burying a small weapon, you are burying it in the ground, what does it mean? It means that you are making peace. Question number 87. Obtain, influence friends, keep a secret or make peace. Answer for bury the hatchet means to make peace. 87 will be C. 88 to 99. The idioms and phrases were pretty simple. And in these idioms and phrases, out those that have been given to you, at least 9 should be correct. 9 should be correct to score well. Now let us move on to question number 88 to 99. This is going to be the last set in this part 2 of the presentation. After that, we will move on to part 3 and part 4 also. This is question number 88 to 99. And here we are going to do 12 one-word substitution. We are going to do 12 one-word substitution. Now let us start. 88. A person who wastes his money on luxury. Luxuriant, extravagant, stingy and luxurious. Now, not difficult one, but close ones. What is luxuriant? Okay, you might feel from luxury we are getting luxuriant. Then we have luxurious, U-R-I-O-U-S, and then we have extravagant. E-X-T-R-A-V-A-G-A-N-T, extravagant. Now, what is luxuriant? Luxuriant means rich and profuse in growth. The weed is luxuriant in this area. That means it is growing very rapidly. Then we have luxurious. Luxurious means full of pleasure and comfort. Full of pleasure and comfort. Then we have extravagant. Extravagant is one who spends a lot. Spends a lot of money. Stingy is one who is miserly. M-I-S-E-R-L-Y, miserly. So these are close options and in this C is the right answer. 88C. 89. Edible. E-D-I-B-L-E, edible. What do we mean by edible? Edible means something which can be edited. E-D-I-T, edited. No, it's not so. Edifying, incorrect, cannot be deleted. That is worth reading. Edible is worth eating. I'm sorry. Edible is going to be something that is worth eating. Edible food, edible apple, edible fruits. Question number 90. A written declaration of government on a political manifesto. It's manifesto, affidavit, dossier or document. Question number 90. Manifesto. What is manifesto? Manifesto, it's a public declaration. It's a public declaration and what will it contain? It will contain policy and aims. Policy and aims of a political party, organization, etc. That is a manifesto. Then we have affidavit. What is an affidavit? An affidavit, this is a written statement. A written statement under oath. A written statement under oath and which can be used as evidence in the court. Then we have dossier. What is a dossier? It is a collection of question number 90C. What is going to be a dossier? A dossier is going to be a collection of documents about a particular person, about a particular event, about a particular subject, etc. That will be known as a dossier. And finally, we have document. Document is going to be a written material which will provide information about something. So these are my four ones. Dossier is a new word. You must know the meaning of dossier. It's material, collected material, collection of documents, etc., about a particular person, etc. So a written declaration of government or a political party, question number 90. My answer for question number 90 is going to be, for this one, question number 90, my answer is going to be a manifesto. A manifesto is the answer. 91. Who is rather fastidious? One who is rather fastidious, question number 91. Rather fastidious will be temptuous. What is temptuous? Temptuous is one with very conflicting emotions. One with very conflicting emotions. Then we have punctual, particular about time. Meticulous. Meticulous is giving great attention to detail. Great attention to details. That is known as meticulous. And then finally we have carefree, one who doesn't take tension at all. So who is going to be one who is rather fastidious? Question number 91. Answer for this is going to be C, meticulous. 92. Very simple. Very simple. Question number 92. Your one word in this paper were pretty simple. Pay attention, heed, glance at, overlook and repair. Question number 92. Heed means to pay attention. Heed means to pay attention. A-T-T-E-N-T-I-O-N. Attention. Glance at. Glance at. What is the meaning of glance at? It means to give a quick short look. It means to give a quick short look before the papers, before an exam. Don't you glance at the important points? Overlook. What is the meaning of overlook? Question number 92. Overlook means to fail to notice. And then finally we have repair. Question number 92. Answer is going to be A, heed. 93. Question number 93. Branch of medicine concerned with children and their illness. Cardiology, osteopathy, pediatrics or morphology. Cardiology, it's related to the heart. Study of diseases related to the heart. Then we have osteopathy. O-S-T-E-O-P-A-T-H-Y. Osteopathy. Now this is a treatment technique in which medicines are not going to be involved. It's a treatment technique. Of the body, if anything has happened to the body, some kind of a sickness, and in this a lot of stress is given on massage, etc. Then we have pediatrics. This is related to diseases of children, etc. And finally we have morphology. M-O-R-P-H-O-L-O-G-Y. Morphology. Question number 93. Morphology. This is the study of forms of things. Study of forms of things is known as morphology. 94. Question number 94. Government by the wealthy. Theocracy, plutocracy, bureaucracy, aristocracy. Theocracy. What is theocracy? Theocracy is a form of government in which the religious head rules in the name of God. Rules in the name of God. That is known as theocracy. Theo is related to God. Then we have plutocracy, P-L-U-T-O, plutocracy. Plutocracy, it's a government by the rich. Bureaucracy, it's a government by the government officials. Government officials, aristocracy, it is a government by people of noble birth. So, government by the wealthy, question number 94, what is going to be the answer? 94, answer will be B, plutocracy. 95. People at a religious gathering. Question number 95. People at a religious gathering. Rabble, mob, congregation or crowd. Question number 95. Rabble. What's a rabble? It's a disorderly crowd. Disorderly crowd is known as a rabble. Mob is also a disorderly crowd. Congregation. Congregation is a group of people who have assembled for a religious purpose. A religious purpose, religious worship, etc. Crowd is simple. So people at a religious gathering is going to be a congregation. 96. Question number 96. A person who collects and or studies stamps. Pioneer, philatelist, pianist and philanthropist. These are my options. Pioneer is somebody who is the first person to do something in a particular field. He is the pioneer in biology, in English, etc. That means he was the one who started it. Philatelist, he is going to be a person who collects or studies stamps. So answer will be B. Pianist, he will play the piano. It's a musical instrument. Philanthropist, one who loves mankind and he believes in a lot of charitable work. Question number 97. Let us take a look. Information about the bird species was inaccessible, and inaccessible has been highlighted. One has to access rare websites to assess it. The meaning of the word in bold is, so what is the meaning of the word inaccessible? That which cannot be read, that which cannot be read is illegible. Handwriting of doctors is illegible. That which cannot be reached, that which cannot be remembered, that which cannot be stretched, that which cannot be reached in inaccessible. During this winter season, certain parts of J&K are inaccessible. During the floods, a lot of parts of Chennai were inaccessible. Question number 98. Guilty of the crime. Daring, suspicious, culpable or ruthless. Question number 98. Answer is C. Culpable, suspicious, you are doubting somebody. Daring means to show courage. Ruthless, cruel, very cold blooded, no emotions at all. That's 98. Answer for this one is C. Culpable. 99. Question number 99. Incapable of being tired, indefatigable, invincible, untiring or tireless. These are my four options. 99. Indefatigable is the answer for question number 99. Fatigue, what is the meaning of fatigue? Fatigue means tiredness. So indefatigable will be the opposite. Invincible is a person who is too strong and can't be defeated. He is going to win all the time. Untiring is to try continuously, persistently. Trying continuously, persistently, without loss of energy and vigor. And then we have tireless. Tireless also means to show great efforts for something. Okay? Great efforts for any cause that you are associated to. One word substitution was simple and try to get all correct. That would be a good score. That would be an excellent score. This was part 2 out of the total 4 presentations for paper 625, which is a previous year paper which appeared in the year 2014. If you wish to join our test series, you can visit us at ssccglpinnacle.com, and over there you will find different kinds of test series for tier 2 and tier 1. Well, for tier 2, there are those with video explanation for each and every question. Total 40 tests are going to be conducted, in which 8000 questions of English and 8000 questions of maths are going to be covered, accompanied by a video explanation. So in case you wish to join us, visit us at ssccglpinnacle.com, because very few videos will be in the public domain. Rest are all going to be private, available only to those who have joined our test series. I wish you all the best, and now let's do part 3. Thank you.